So, hi students. So today another DBP is there. So that is some synopsis, some brief chapter we have to give to you. So see, let us today chapter is haloalkanes and halogens, haloalkanes and halogens. So remember one point. So you have to basic information. You have to idea about the nomenclature. So why? Because in the examination point of view, nomenclature will give. Sometimes only the equations will give. That means nomenclature only gives. They will not give the any structure of the molecules. Okay. So that's why all nomenclature is same only. Already you know that nomenclature part of you. Okay. So what is the primary alkyl? Haloalkanes, halogens means alkyl halides and aryl halides. So alkyl halide, primary alkyl halide is there, secondary alkyl halide is there, tertiary alkyl halide. When we called primary alkyl halide. So primary alkyl halide when we called, so halogen attached to only primary carbon. So halogen attached to only primary carbon. So this is primary alkyl halide. So this is primary. So halogen attached to secondary carbon. Secondary carbon. This is secondary alkyl. So halogen attached to tertiary carbon. This is tertiary alkyl halide. So primary alkyl halide, secondary alkyl halide, and tertiary alkyl halide. Is it clear? And this allylic halide. Allylic halide means what? So halogen attached to sp3 carbon atom. So immediately, so carbon double bond. It is sp3 hybridization. So this is allylic. So benzylic means what? Same. So halogen attached to sp3 carbon atom. Immediately carbon double. It is sp3 carbon. So it is benzylic halide. So vinylic halide means what? It is sp3. Halogen attached to sp3 carbon atom. So immediately carbon double bond. It is benzylic halide. It is allylic halide. Halide, it is benzylic halide. And next one is so vinylic halide. So vinylic halide means halogen attached to sp2 carbon and immediately carbon double bond. That is vinylic halide. This is vinylic halide. So next one is aryl halide. So halogen attached to aromatic carbon of benzene ring. So that is called aryl halides. Aryl halides. Generally it is classification. Okay. So classification of haloalkanes and halogens. Okay. So primary alkyl halide, secondary tertiary alkyl halide, allylic halide, benzylic halide, vinylic halide and aryl halides. Okay. So this is the classification of haloalkanes and halogens. So coming to the geminal dihalides and bisphenol dihalides. What is the geminal dihalides? What is the bisphenol dihalides? Geminal dihalides and bisphenol dihalides. What is the geminal dihalides? Whenever halogen attached to only one carbon. Two halogen atom attached to one carbon atom. Okay. So for example, I would like write through like this. CH3, CH halogen, here is X. X means halogen. It is what? Geminal dihalides. Geminal dihalides. What is the geminal dihalides? Two halogen atom attached to only one carbon atom. Bisphenol dihalides means two halogen atom attached to adjacent carbon atom. This is bisphenol dihalides. What is the geminal dihalides? Two halogen atom attached to only one carbon. Two halogen atom is attached to two halogen atom. So this halogen, two halogen atom is only one carbon. That is geminal dihalides. In case two halogen atom attached to adjacent carbon atom, that is bisphenol dihalides. It is very important. What is the bisphenol? What is the geminal dihalides? Okay. See, coming to the preparations. So preparation of alcohols. Okay, so preparation, physical and chemical properties, very important of topics. So preparation of alcohols, so from preparation of haloalkanes from alcohols, we have to haloalkanes means what? Alkyl halides from alcohols. See, let us see. So when all alcohols react with hydrogen halide, can take gives the alkyl halides plus water molecule. If this is alcohol is primary alcohols, okay, so we require catalyst zinc chloride. If in case it is alcohol is secondary and tertiary alcohol, secondary or tertiary alcohols do not require any catalyst, simply. Okay. So alcohols are react with hydrogen halide. Hydrogen halide means here is X equal to chlorine, bromine and iodine. Here also. So whenever this alcohol is primary alcohol, how to identify primary alcohol means OH group attached to only primary carbon. Secondary tertiary alcohols does not require any catalyst, zinc chloride. Okay. So alcohols are react with alcohols react with hydrogen alloy to give the alkyl halides. This is very important reactions. If in case primary alkyl halide we require catalyst zinc chloride, secondary tertiary alcohols does not require any zinc chloride. Why? Because it is more stable only. Okay. And next one is, so important preparation of alcohols. Important preparation of alkyl. So whenever alcohols react with thionyl chloride SOCl2, this is called thionyl chloride, to give the alkyl halide plus sulfur dioxide plus HCl. Okay, so this is what thionyl chloride. This is thionyl chloride. This is thionyl chloride. Thionyl chloride. So this alkyl. These both are gases. Both are gases. So alcohols are react with thionyl chloride to produce the alkyl halides and sulfur dioxide and HCl. So this is the best preparation method of. Best preparation method. Okay, it is the best preparation methods in the preparation of alkyl halide from alcohols. So why? Because both the by the products of both are gases. Sulfur dioxide is gas and HCl is also gas. So alcohols, from alcohols we have to prepare the alkyl halide. So which is the best preparation method? Alcohols are react with thionyl chloride to give the alkyl halide and give sulfur dioxide and HCl. So this reaction is very important. Why? Because this is the best preparation method. This reaction also called Dardenne's reaction. The Ivo reaction. This reaction is called Dardenne's reaction. Very important reaction name. According to PU textbook, there is no need. But in entrance, what is the name of this reaction? Dardenne's reaction. Dardenne's reaction. Okay. Is it clear? And then alcohols are react to also phosphorus trihalides. Alcohols are react with the phosphorus trihalides. Alcohols react with the phosphorus trihalides. Phosphorus trihalides to produce the alkyl halides and gives the H3PO3. H3PO3. To give the H3PO3. So these are also reactions. So many reactions is there. So alcohols are very important, this reaction. Okay. So alcohols are react with thionyl chloride. This is the best preparation method. Why? Because by the products, both are gas only. So easily you can remove this one. And this reaction is called Dardenne's reaction. It is from alcohols. From alcohols also, we have to prepare the alkyl halides. And next one is, from alkenes also we have to prepare hydrocarbons. Okay, hydrocarbons, alkenes. From alkenes also we have to prepare the alkyl halides. From alkenes. Okay, so from alkenes we have to prepare. For example, C double bond C react with hydrogen halides to produce the alkyl halides. General equation. So whenever this alkene is, when alkene is unsymmetrical, when alkene is unsymmetrical alkene, not symmetrical, it is unsymmetrical alkene, follows the Markovnikov's rule. So Markovnikov rule. So what is the Markovnikov rule? So negative part is added to which carbon is having less number of hydrogen atom. So negative part added to which carbon is having less number of hydrogen atom according to Markovnikov's rule. Already know Markovnikov's rule. So for example, take CH3CH double bond CH2. Okay. So react with hydrogen chloride or hydrogen bromide, you can take example that is. So among this one, so Markovnikov rule, okay. So Markovnikov rule, so negative part is what? Bromide ion, Br minus. Negative part is Br minus. So Br minus H plus. So negative part is added to which carbon is having less number of hydrogen. So here is negative part attacked to here only. That's why this is the CH3, CHBr, CH3. 2-bromopropane is the product. 2-bromopropane is the name. 2-bromopropane. So negative part attacked to which carbon is having less number of hydrogens. That is 2 bromo propane. Is it clear? Okay. So from alkenes, whenever alkenes is react with bromine water. Okay. So bromine. So addition of bromine to alkenes. Okay. Reduce bromical gas. So whenever alkene is, it is according to Markovnikov. When alkenes are unsymmetrical, unsymmetrical means what? It is not symmetrical. Unsymmetrical. Why? Because both are different. When our bond break, it is different side. This is different. Okay. So when our alkenes react with bromine water. Bromine water, reddish bromine water. So react with vicinal dibromate. For example, you can take ethene. Ethene react with bromine water to produce the vicinal dibromate. Color is discharge. Color discharge. Here is bromine reddish brown color. Reddish brown color. To produce vicinal dibromates. Vicinal dibromates is produced. So this reaction is bromine is react with alkene to produce na vicinal dibromates. Okay. And next one is from halogen exchange reaction. Very important halogen exchange reaction. Winkelstein reaction and Schwartz reaction. It is compulsory question in exam. PU point of already written PU exam. Winkelstein reaction. What is the Winkelstein reaction? Halogen exchange reaction. Simple, I will write here. Reaction. So alkyl iodate react with sodium iodate to produce the alkyl iodate and sodium halide. So it is alkyl halide. So alkyl halides is react with sodium iodine in the presence of dry acetone to produce this one. So here is halogen is chlorine and bromine. Okay. So it is sodium iodide is soluble in methanol and acetone. It's methanol and acetone. Here is this sodium halide. What after formation of sodium chloride and sodium bromide, this is insoluble in methanol and acetone. So whenever alkyl halide react with sodium iodide to produce alkyl iodide. Okay. So alkyl chloride, alkyl bromide react with sodium iodide in the presence of dry acetone to produce the alkyl iodide and sodium halide. Sodium halide, that is sodium chloride, sodium bromide. This reaction is called Winkelstein reaction. Here is sodium iodide is the soluble in methanol and acetone, but here is sodium chloride, sodium bromide insoluble in methanol and acetone. It is very important point. Okay. This is called Winkelstein reaction. And next one is Schwartz reaction. Schwartz reaction used for what? So to prepare the alkyl fluorides. So by the alkyl bromates and iodates. Okay. To prepare the alkyl fluorides by the alkyl chlorides, alkyl bromates and alkyl iodates. In the presence of metallic fluorides such as silver fluoride, mercury fluoride, cobalt fluoride. So for example, you have to take methyl bromate react in the presence of metallic fluoride, silver fluoride to produce methyl fluoride plus silver bromide. Okay, not only this metallic fluoride, not only this one. So cobalt fluoride, mercury fluoride. Okay, so boron, silver fluoride, cobalt fluoride, mercury fluoride, and extra. This reaction is called Schwartz reaction. So whenever alkyl bromates or alkyl iodates and chlorides react with metallic fluorides such as silver fluoride, cobalt fluoride, mercury fluoride. Okay, so gives the alkyl fluorides. This reaction is called Schwartz reaction. Or you can take anyone. This reaction is called Schwartz reaction. Okay. So this is the preparation of haloalkanes. So preparation of haloalkanes. Simply remember preparation of electrophilic substitution reaction. So toluene is react with in the presence of halogen. Preparation of haloalkanes. So toluene react with halogen in the presence of Lewis acid FeCl3 or AlCl3 to produce the ortho halotoluene and Para halo toluene. Among this one, which one is major? Para position is the major only. And next from amines, primary aromatic amines. From primary aromatic amines, that is aniline react with sodium nitrate HCl to produce the benzene diazonium chloride salt. This is called Sandomierz here. So this benzene diazonium chloride salt, this benzene diazonium chloride salt react with cuprous chloride to produce the chlorobenzene. So this reaction is called Sandomierz reaction. So by the loss of nitrogen, okay, so this reaction is called, Sandomierz reaction. So that is the important, these two reactions are very important, Sandomierz reaction. So however, some cuprous halides, you can take cuprous halides. Cuprous chloride means chlorobenzene. You can take cuprous bromide means bromobenzene. You have to take here cuprous halide, Cu2X2. Okay, so that is, you have to take anyone. However, benzene diazonium chloride, you have to prepare salt, simply potassium iodide, iodobenzene. You have to prepare the iodobenzene, simply shaking with iodine, potassium iodide to produce nitrogen. Simply shaking with potassium iodide to produce iodobenzene. Here is chlorobenzene, bromobenzene, depending on, here is halogen is chlorine or bromine. Okay, chlorobenzene, bromobenzene. If in case, however, you have to prepare iodobenzene, benzene diazonium chloride salt, simply shaking with potassium iodide to produce the iodobenzene and nitrogen is released. Okay, this is the preparation of haloarenes, important of reactions. And coming to the one more, so now physical property, Simply remember, so whenever more surface area having, more boiling point. This point you remember. So more surface area have more boiling point, more BPT. For example, N-pentane, CH3, CH2, 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 CH3, N-pentane, and isopentane, CH3, CH3, CH2, CH3. This is isopentane, CH3. This is neopentane. So N-pentane, isopentane, neopentane. Among this one, which one is more? Among these three, which one is more? Okay. So among this one, which one is more? So having boiling point. See, whenever more surface area having more boiling point. This is less surface area. This is very, very less surface. This is only surface area. This is the surface. So more surface area, more boiling point, less surface area, less. Why? Because due to intermolecular hydrogen bond. Is it clear? And next one is, so nucleophilic substitution reaction. So alkyl halides involve the nucleophilic substitution reaction. So nucleophilic substitution reaction means what? Nucleophilic substitution. Nucleophilic substitution reactions. So SN1, SN2 reaction. It is very, very important. So simply nucleophilic substitution reaction. One nucleophile substituted by another nucleophile. For example, so this is nucleophile. Alkyl halide. This is nucleophile. So this is. Okay. So halide ions is better good leaving groups. It is a halide ion. Halogen is departs as a halide ion. It is a good leaving group. And incoming nucleophile attacks to this one. So it is leaving group like this. So this is the nucleophilic substitution. One nucleophile substituted by another nucleophile. That is called nucleophilic substitution reaction. So many nucleophilic substitution reaction is there. Okay. So whenever water is there, water is react with alcohols. So in that water is, what is the nucleophile? OH minus. So water is react with alkyl halide to produce the alcohols. So like that, sodium cyanide is there. So in sodium cyanide, what is the nucleophile? Cl minus. So for example, alkyl halides react with sodium cyanide. What is the nucleophile here? Is Cl minus. It is C plus. So alkyl cyanides plus NaX. So it is, here is one nucleophile. Cl minus is nucleophile halogenous. So cyanides are having cyanides is called ambidentate nucleophiles, cyanides and nitriles, nitro group. Why? Because it is having two donate atoms. Carbon is donated to the alkyl halide of carbon atom and nitrogen also. Okay, sodium cyanide and silver cyanide. Okay, so that is the one nucleophile substitute. If in case water is there, alkyl halide react with water. Okay, so alkyl halide react with water, so it is nucleophile. So alcohols plus HX, hydrogen halides. Alcohols plus HX. So one nucleophile substituted by another nucleophile. So many nucleophile is there. Sodium cyanides, esters. Okay, so ammonia. Ammonia also. Alkyl halides are react with ammonia. So gives the primary amines plus hydrogen halide. So alkyl halide is react with primary amines. It is all of nucleophiles only, and to produce hydrogen halides. So alkyl halide react with this secondary amine to produce the tertiary amines. So like this. So many nucleophiles, one nucleophile, these all are nucleophiles, ammonia, RnH2, these all are right. Nucleophiles means which compounds having extra electrons, that is called nucleophiles. Is it clear? So nucleophiles are two types of reaction is there, SN2 reaction is there and SN1 reaction is there. So SN2 and SN1 reaction. SN2 reaction means what? Simply I will write here SN2 reaction and SN1 reaction. So SN2 reaction is and SN1 reaction. So SN2 and SN1, what is the difference here? So SN2 reaction means bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. So SN1 is unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. In SN2 reaction, what is the order? Order of reaction? Second order. This is first order. So here is, so order is there. So rate of the reaction depends on concentration of alkyl halides and nucleophile both. But in SN1 reaction, rate of the reaction depends on only concentration of alkyl halides. Only first order, only concentration of alkyl halides. Okay, here is important points, this you remember overall. Okay, so in this, so next one is, here is, so this what? So polar protic solvents, it is required polar protic solvent. Which solvent is what? Polar protic solvent. It is polar aprotic solvent. Polar aprotic solvent. Here is, there is no intermediate is produced. Here is intermediates are produced. That is primary, secondary, comma, tertiary and benzylic carbocations. That carbocations are produced. Carbocations. Intermediates are primary, secondary, tertiary, carbocations. So here is, it is involved the two steps. Okay, it is involved the two steps. So here is alkyl halide. Which alkyl halide is more reactive? Primary alkyl halide is more reactive than secondary. Primary alkyl halide more reactive than secondary alkyl halide. And it is tertiary alkyl halide is more reactive. In this one, which alkyl halide is more reactive? Tertiary alkyl halide is more reactive than secondary alkyl halide. Exactly opposite than primary alkyl halide. Primary alkyl halide. So alkyl halide's reactivity, which one is the more reactivity towards SN1 reaction means what? So tertiary alkyl halide is more reactive than secondary alkyl halide, then primary alkyl halide. Is it clear? And next one is in this, in that, that is, that means reaction product is there. In this, transition state is produced. transition state. In single step transition state is produced. That is trigonal bipyramidal structure. That is trigonal bipyramidal structure. Trigonal bipyramidal structure. It is carbocation is produced. Trigonal planar carbocations. Trigonal planar. Okay, if this transition state is produced, that is structure is trigonal planar. It is involved single step. Okay, so this is the one is the SN to SN1 mechanism. See, very very important. So order of the reaction is second order reaction, it is first order reaction. So rate of the reaction depends on concentration of alkyl and nucleophile in SN2. It is react involved in the only only alkyl ions. It is polar aprotic solvents. It is polar aprotic solvents, polar protic. What is the difference polar aprotic and protic? Polar aprotic, aprotic means which compound is does not releases the proton, that is called aprotic solvent. Protic solvents means so which compounds is releases the H plus ion, that is called protic solvents. In this there is no intermediate, here is intermediate switch produced. Here is single step, here is two steps, more than one step is simple, more than one steps. Here is SN2 reaction, primary alkaloid more reactive than secondary alkaloid, then tertiary alkaloid. In this tertiary alkaloid more reactive than secondary alkaloid, then primary alkaloid. In this transition state is produced, in this carbocation is produced. Okay. So in that, so during chemical reactions, stereochemical aspects. So in SN2 reaction, stereochemical reaction is what? Is SN2 reaction, stereochemical reaction. In SN2 reaction, stereochemical reaction is inversion configuration. Inversion. We have to take the tertiary alkyl halide, so that is completely inversion complex. R configuration means S configuration. R means what? Rectus. Okay, right side and left side, that is. So in this SN1, SN2 reaction, so stereochemical reaction is what happened? Inversion configuration after formation of product. In SN1 reaction is racemic mixture is product is produced. In stereochemistry, racemic mixture means what? 50% is retention, 50% is inversion. That is called racemic mixture. Is it clear what I am saying? So whenever, if in case SN2 reaction is involved optically active halides. When we called optically active halides, whenever halogen group, so which carbon is having four different group is called, that is chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon or stereochemical stereo center. So such type of compounds involve the SN2 reaction, so completely inversion configuration. Same SN1 reaction also, whenever tertiary alkyl halide, that means so optically active alkyl, that means which carbon is having four different groups, so that is involve the SN1 mechanism, that is product is produced, the 50% retention, 50% is inversion, that is called racemic mixture. In SN1 reaction is racemic mixture is product is produced when so optically active alkyl halides involved. In SN2 reaction is optically active halides is involved, so inversion product is produced. So this is SN2 SN1 reaction. Very very important these reactions. Okay, so which carbocation is more, which one is, so in SN2 reaction primary alkaloid, why primary alkaloid? Why? Because it is approaching, way of approaching is the back of the carbon atom, which halogen is bonded to carbon atom. Okay, when our bulky steric hindrances happens, tertiary alkaloid, that's why it is tertiary alkaloid is more unstable in this SN2 reaction. But in SN1 reaction, depending on stability of carbocations. Is it clear what I'm saying? So this is SN2 and SN1 reaction.